Hi, I'm Livo. Welcome to my channel. Today I'm going to show you how to make this amazing pirate treasure chest. Arr!
So I'm going to be doing this project with just a little bit of scrap wood that I had in the shed. It's not really that much. I think this is going to work for what we want to do.
First of all,
we're going to do a cross cut to 8.5 inches. 8.5 is going to be the length of our treasure chest. I'm going to sand these pieces before I keep on going, because later on we're going to try to clamp this with tape. So I'm going to cut some strips of wood that are going to be in an angle. That angle for me is going to be 12 degrees. So later on I can glue them and make an arch to put on top of the chest. To set up the angle on my blade, I'm going to use my digital angle gauge. I am raising my blade all the way up, and I want to put my digital angle gauge on my table to take that as a reference. I am going to calibrate it. Now, I already did that, so that's why you see here that it says that it's on 0 degrees. So when I put it on my blade, I want to make sure that it's not touching any of the teeth of the blade. Since I was on the 90 degrees after setting it down on the table, I want to make sure it goes to 78. Okay, and if you get it to 78.1 or 77.9, that's not going to make a big difference on your project.
What I want to do first is cut this edge. This is going to give me the angle for the first strip. I'm going to make him around an inch wide. So I am going to lower my blade to just a little bit higher than that board to make it as safe as possible, just a little bit. I am taking as a reference just the highest point of the blade and putting it an inch away from that fence, and I'm going to set it right there. And once I cut that, I'm going to flip the board like this and make the next cut and keep doing the cuts like that. I cut 7 strips of wood with that 12 degree angle, and I am going to just put a couple of pieces of tape on the top, which are going to help me keep it in place. Once you have those angles, you're going to turn it around. You're going to put some glue on this strips right here, and we're going to put it like that, and you're going to come up with this arch like this. Later on we're gonna put a piece of wood right here. I set up my blade back to the 90 degrees. What I'm gonna do is cut some strips that are gonna be 2.5 inches wide. That's gonna be the height of my box. I mean, 2 strips of 8.5 inches and 2 strips of 4.75 of it. The reason I'm making the sides 4.75 is when I put my arch together, that's the distance from one side to the other one. I'm gonna make the bottom of the box with this scrap wood. Instead of making it 8.5 by 4.75, I'm gonna make those an inch bigger. So let's say if the box is 8.5, I'm gonna cut this at 9.5 so I can have 1/2 inch on its side. Same thing I'm gonna do with this. Instead of making it 4.75, I'm gonna make it 5.75. We're gonna have this as the bottom. It's gonna have an overhang of 1/2 inch on each side. We have cut our pieces that are 8.5 inches long and 2.5 inches tall. We're gonna make dovetail joints on each side that are gonna go right here, which is gonna be 4.75 inches. We have our arch that is 4.75 inches that is gonna sit right there.
so we're back in the shop. This dried overnight. It looks pretty good. Nice and square. We're just gonna sand it and make it look nicer. We're gonna remove all that glue. Same thing with this. Those nails, that's brat nails, work pretty good. Everything is nice and flat. So
I got those hinges from Home Depot, so I'm just gonna set them up on the box.
Make your comments below and don't forget to subscribe.